So take 37.
All right, I'm going to reset this guy, and we are going to do it.
Eric.
You're not in the show.
I'm in the show.
We're all in the show.
We're all in this together.
Hey! Hey! Welcome to This Week at First Press. I'm going to be honest with you, there have been a lot of takes of this. But it's cool. We're moving into the first thing, which we have Sarah here. Sarah, if you don't know, is our Director of Christian Education.
He got it right this time.
The first time I got it right today. So Sarah is here to talk about something that's happening tonight, if you're watching this on Wednesday when it comes out. Sarah, that is the Bridge Program.
That's right.
Talk about it.
All right, so I built a bridge because tonight is the start of our Bridge Program, which is designed to help connect you from one Sunday to the next so that you can reconnect with God and with your church family in the middle of the week. So here's what we have going on tonight. Starting at 5 o'clock, we'll have the Children's Choir and More program going on for an hour, which is pretty self-explanatory. I did want parents to know that even though we're starting at 5, that first quarter of the hour from 5 to 5:15 is going to be game time for the kids to blow off some steam. So if you are rushing to get here after picking up kids from school or work or whatever's going on, you won't miss too much if you can't get here right at 5. So don't sweat it.
And
I would sweat it. Don't sweat
that
it.
That levels the playing field for me, who's going to win all the games.
Well, you don't even know what games we're playing yet.
Are you going to play dodgeball? Because I can definitely beat 6th graders in dodgeball.
Where are we going to play dodgeball?
Right here.
Okay, game to be determined. So starting at 5:30, the bridge dinner will be offered down in Social Hall. That's served from 5:30 to 6:15. The kids will come down at 6 when we're done with Children's Choir to join their families to eat. And the meal this week is?
End of summer cookout.
There we go. Should be a winner for everybody. And then starting at 6:30, we'll have 3 opportunities for adult education here at the church. In the chapel, Pastor Greg is going to be leading the Pastor's Corner class, and they're looking at the book of Nehemiah for the next couple of weeks. Upstairs, the Women's Bible Study is going to be starting a new study on a spiritual gifts curriculum, which was offered several years ago and was very well received.
Absolutely.
And so we're offering it again, and we're excited to see what comes out of it this
Bring
time
it
around.
Back.
And then there's going to be a men's study led by Jim Serum, also upstairs, on the book Triumph of Christianity by Bart Ehrman.
Bart Ehrman.
So if you want to go to any of those adult opportunities, we will have childcare for babies through 5th grade.
Sweet.
We're going to meet down in the nursery every Wednesday night around 6:30 before these classes start. We'll see who's there, what ages they are, and then we'll decide where we're going to be.
Cool.
But we're trying to have something for everyone, including...
Oh, yes, from 6:15 to 7:30 on Wednesday
nights. I almost forgot that I...
Yeah. Oh, wait, what? middle school Bible study will be happening in the high school room upstairs.
That's
in the church. It is a little bit confusing. It's in the room with the cool lights in it. But that is led by Mary Hambleton. So if you are coming to dinner and are in middle school, you're welcome to stay for it. If you aren't able to make the dinner but want to come to the Bible study, that is okay as well. Again, 6:15, 7:30 upstairs in our normal youth room. So, yeah.
Guys, so far we have not boshed this.
This has been good, but this is where I screwed
this is
up
where
really bad.
This is where it gets hairy, so just hang on. Okay?
So, we want to tell you about this coming Sunday. And the first thing is that it is Restaurant Festival Day here in Westchester this coming Sunday, which means from around 8:30, they close down most of the main roads to prepare for that. So make sure when you're leaving your house for church this coming Sunday that you save yourself some extra time, give yourself a little extra time to get here so that you don't miss worship. And so you're not rushed or feel like you are late, whatever.
Yeah, or rushed. That's
normal, same thing.
And then
you know.
Once you're here, what's
yes.
going on?
Once you're here, we are also serving some food that is available to be bought, and that is for Muffin Mania, which is our fundraiser for Rise Against Hunger. That is happening, the meal packaging event is happening here October 14th down in Social Hall from 12 to 2. And so all you need to know for this Sunday is you need to bring money to buy muffins and bring an empty stomach ready to eat muffins, because that is what this Sunday is all about, other than...
Oh my gosh, this is the last segment and we still haven't screwed it up. And I have a minute and 40 minutes, or 40 seconds, to talk to you about the ministry fair, so get ready. If you have ever thought about getting involved or plugged in here at First Press, say that you wanted to, what are some opportunities? Serve with a youth group, get involved in children's ministry, maybe be a Sunday school teacher. Maybe go to homes and serve communion in the home work. worship kind of groups, there are all kinds of ways that you can get involved, and you can learn about them this Sunday at the ministry fair.
Absolutely.
There are going to be ministry leaders stationed at tables around Fellowship Hall where you can ask any question you want to. Maybe you have a hard homework problem and you need some help with it.
No.
Ask that question. No, don't ask that. Ask the ministry leaders about their ministry areas and potentially how you could be involved, ways to serve in that area, etc. There's also going to be a card that Steve has held up a couple times in the last several Sundays where you can fill your name out, fill your email out, and drop it in just to kind of say, hey, I'm interested in a conversation. Not a commitment, I want to have a conversation. Not a commitment. Sure.
I want to have a conversation.
But I want to have a conversation. I am trying to burn 20 minutes.
No.
So the other side of that is,
go ahead,
if you have some like skill or interest that you would love to share, but you have no idea how that could connect to church, just come up to one of these tables.
Yeah, we'll get you plugged
in. And we'll figure it out for
you.
That's
what I'm talking about.
And who knows
what's
going to come out of
that. That is at the coffee hour. So between the 9 and 10:42 service is when we'll be doing that. So this has been This Week at First Press. We got it right. Have a great week. Take care.
Yes! Woo!